सारे अफसर भी खड़े हैं सब भाई।
भाषण है सीधा
बस।
हाँ एक मिनट
We are happy to welcome Excellencies and the other dignitaries. His Excellency, the Governor of Tamil Nadu, Shri Banwari Lal Purohit, welcome. Her Excellency, the Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry, Dr. Kiran Bedi, welcome. The Union Minister of State for Finance and Shipping, Tirupon Radhakrishnan. The Honorable Minister of Electricity, Tamil Nadu, Tirupi Thangamani. The Honorable Minister of Law, Courts and Prisons, Tamil Nadu, Tirusivi Sanmugam. The Honorable Chief Minister of Puducherry, Mr. Narayan Swami, and the Chairman of the Auroville Foundation, Dr. Karan Singh. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi. Shri Aurobindo dreamed marvelous dreams. On the 15th of August 1947, he put these five dreams in a public message to newly independent India. Dr. Astar Patel is offering the text of these dreams to the Honorable Prime Minister. The audience may please rise for the Tamil Thai Vartha.
Nirarum kadalodutta nilamadandu kezhilozhugum Sirarum vadanamena thigizhparatha kandam idhil Thekkanamum adhil sirandha dravidanar thirunadum Thakka siru thiraipadathu kandam idhil திலக வாசனை போல் அனைத்துலகும் இன்பமுற எத்திசையும் புகழ் பறக்க இருந்த பெரும் தமிழனங்கே தமிழனங்கே உன் சீரிலமை திறம் வியந்து செயல் மறந்து வாழ்த்துதுமே வாழ்த்துதுமே வாழ்த்துதுமே
We request Dr. Karan Singh, the chairman of the Auroville Foundation, to please welcome the Honorable Prime Minister on Auroville's behalf.
The Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Bhai Modi, distinguished personalities on the dais, members of the audience here in this Shri Aurobindo auditorium, and around the country and the world on television, and friends. On behalf of the entire Auroville community, it is my honor and privilege to welcome you, Mr. Prime Minister, other dignitaries and guests to our Golden Jubilee celebrations. This unique experiment in collective sadhana flowed from the spiritual power and integral wisdom of Sri Aurobindo and the vision and dynamism of his spiritual collaborator, the Mother, who exactly 50 years ago laid the foundations of Auroville in that urn that you see on the photograph here. Sri Aurobindo's great classic, The Ideal of Human Unity, mirrors our ancient concept of Vasudeva Kutumbakam, the world as a family. It is reflected here in Auroville. There are 50 nationalities here in Auroville. 20 languages are spoken. Many cultures are flourishing here. In 50 years, the Aurovillians have achieved miracles. They have constructed the Matri Mandir. Mr. Prime Minister, you've just seen it and meditated there. an architectural marvel based precisely on the vision of the mother. They have converted a barren, sandy beach strip into a green and flourishing community, an environmental achievement that can be a model for the rest of India. There are dozens of startups here. In fact, Auroville itself is a massive startup. Over the years, UNESCO has passed as many as 5 resolutions supporting Auroville. The latest was passed at the November meeting of the General Council, specifically in the context of our Golden Jubilee. So you had yourself visited UNESCO and offered floral tribute to the statue of Sri Aurobindo at the entrance of UNESCO, the only one of its kind in that great institution. Friends, in an era beset by transition and turmoil, conflict and violence, Auroville seeks to be a model of a township where men and women of all creeds and cultures, all races and colors, all customs and languages can live together in creative harmony. Only India could support such an effort by setting up the Auroville Foundation under an act of parliament in keeping with our rich, inclusive cultural heritage. We are grateful to the Government of India through the HRD Ministry for all the support they continue to give to Auroville, supplemented by substantial fundraising activities by the Aurovillians themselves, a truly creative public-private partnership. And we also are grateful for the special support we have received for the Golden Jubilee, which has helped us upgrade our infrastructure and carry forward many of our projects. Mr. Prime Minister, your presence here at my invitation at the Golden Jubilee is a source of great encouragement to Auroville, giving us a new impetus to develop as envisaged in the famous Upanishadic verse, let us work together, let us achieve together, let us be nourished together, let there be no hatred between us. Sahana vavatu, sahano bhunaktu, sahi viryam karvavahi, tejasvina avadhi tamastu, ma vidvishavahi. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. G. We now request the Prime Minister to please release a few. The first thing we're going to begin with is the postage stamps. The Indian Department of Posts is bringing out a commemorative postage stamp on the occasion of Auroville's 50th anniversary. We request the Chief Postmaster General of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry Circle to please present the album to the Prime Minister so that he may release the stamp. Thank you, sir. The Sri Aurobindo International Institute of Educational Research has brought out a book, An Integral Education for Growth and Blossoming. It is intended as a practical guide for parents and teachers. We request the Honorable Prime Minister to please release this book. Auroville's architecture is unique. The Auroville Pioneer Architects series presents a monograph on the 50 years of work of two of our earliest architects. Piero and Gloria's work is distinct for its elegance and sympathy. We request the Prime Minister to please release this monograph. Humanscapes is a demonstration project on sustainable urban habitats for the future. Please look at your screens. We will show you a short montage. Can we please have the montage? Thank you. While the project's dream is to build housing for 500 youth, to coincide with Auroville's 50th anniversary, the first cluster of 50 units is ready, and we request the Auroville youth who is receiving the keys from the Prime Minister to please come to the dais. And we request the Honorable Prime Minister to inaugurate the project. Thank you, sir. We request you, sir, now to please address the audience.
Shri Banwarilal Purohit ji, Dr. Kiran Bedi ji, Shri V. Narayan Sami, Shri Pawan Radhakrishnan ji, Minister from Puducherry and Tamil Nadu, Dr. Karan Singh ji, ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to be here today on the occasion of the Golden Jubilee Week of Auroville. Sri Aurobindo's vision of India's spiritual leadership continues to inspire us even today. Indeed, Auroville is a manifestation of that vision. Over the last 5 decades, it has emerged as a hub of social, cultural, educational, economic, and spiritual innovation. Friends, it is important today to remember the vast extent of action and thought of Sri Aurobindo, a man of action, a philosopher, a poet. There were so many facets to his character, and each of them was dedicated to the good of the nation and humanity. In the words of Rabindranath Tagore, Rabindranath, O Aurobindo, bows to thee. O friend, my country's friend, O voice incarnate, free of India's soul. Friends, as the mother had observed, Auroville was to be a universal town. The purpose of Auroville is to realize human unity. The large gathering here today is a reflection of that idea. For ages, India has been a spiritual destination for the world. The great universities of Nalanda and Takshila hosted students from all over the world. Many of the world's great religions were born here. They motivate people from all walks of life to take to a spiritual path in their day-to-day dealings. Recently, the United Nations had declared June 21st as International Day of Yoga, recognizing a great Indian tradition. Auroville had brought together men and women, young and old, cutting across boundaries and identities. I understand that Auroville's charter was handwritten in French by the Divine Mother herself. According to the charter, the mother set 5 high principles for Auroville. The first high principle of Auroville is that it belongs to all humanity. This is reflection of our ancient credo of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The world is one family. I am told that the inauguration ceremony of Auroville in 1968 was attended by delegates of 124 nations. I learned that today it has over 2,400 residents from 49 countries. This leads us to the second high principle of Auroville. Anyone who is willingly in service of the divine consciousness is entitled to live in Auroville. Maharishi Aurobindo's philosophy of consciousness integrates not just humans, but the entire universe. This matches with the ancient saying in the Ishavasya Upanishad, Ishavasyam Idam Sarvam. This has been translated by Mahatma Gandhi to mean everything down to the tiniest atom is divine. The third founding principle of Auroville is that it will emerge at the bridge between the past and the future. In one looks at where the world and India were in 1968, when Auroville was founded, the world was living in compartments and in a state of Cold War. The idea of Auroville saw the world getting integrated by trade, travel, and communication. Auroville was conceived with the vision of developing the whole of humanity in one small area. This world showed that the future would seen in an integrated world. The fourth founding principle of Auroville is that it will connect the spiritual and material approaches of the contemporary world. As the world progresses materially through science and technology, it will increasingly long for a need spiritual orientation for social order and stability. At Auroville, the material and the spiritual coexistence in harmony. The fifth basic principle of Auroville is that it will be a place of unending learning and constant progress so that it never stagnates. The progress of humanity calls for continuous thinking and rethinking so that the human mind does not become frozen into one idea. The very fact that Auroville has brought together such huge diversity of people and ideas makes dialogue and debate natural. Indian society is fundamentally diverse. It has fostered dialogue and a philosophic tradition. Auroville showcases this ancient Indian tradition to the world by bringing together global diversity. India has always allowed mutual respect and coexistence of different religions and culture. India is home to the age-old tradition of Gurukul, where learning is not confined to classrooms, where life is a living laboratory. Auroville, too, has developed as a place of unending and lifelong education. In ancient times, our sages and rishis who perform yajna to begin great endeavors. Occasionally, those yajnas would shape the course of history. One such yajna for unity was performed here exactly 50 years ago. Men and women brought soils from all parts of the world. In the mixing of the soils began the journey of oneness. The world has received positive vibrations from Auroville in many forms over the years. Be it unending education, environment regeneration, renewable energy, organic agriculture, appropriate building technologies, water management, or waste management. Auroville has been a pioneer. You have done a lot to promote quality education in the country. On the occasion of 50 years of Auroville, I hope you can enhance your efforts in this direction. Serving young minds through education will be a big tribute to Sri Aurobindo and the mother. Many of you may not be aware, but I too have been a follower of your efforts on education. Sri Kirit Bhai Joshi, an ardent disciple of Sri Aurobindo and the mother, was an eminent educationalist. He was also my education advisor when I was the Chief Minister of Gujarat. He's not amongst us today, but his contribution to the field of education in India is worth remembering. Friends, the Rigveda states, Ano Bhadraha, Kratvo Yantu Vishvataha. Let noble thoughts come to us from all sides. May Auroville continues to come up with ideas to empower the ordinary citizens of this country. May people from far and wide bring with them new ideas. May Auroville become the center where these ideas are synthesized. May Auroville serve as a beacon to the world. May it be the guardian which calls for breaking down narrow walls of the mind. May it continue to invite everyone to celebrate the possibilities of humanity's oneness. May the spirit of Maharshi Aurobindo and the Divine Mother continue to guide Auroville to the eventual fulfillment of its lofty founding vision. Thank you. Thank you very much.
You have honored us with your presence. You have honored Auroville with your words. We express our deep gratitude. In 1961, Mother gave a message to a New Year message, public message. She spoke about this wonderful world of delight that was waiting at our gates for our call to come down upon earth. This is our aspiration. If humanity could work together at their best level, bringing the soul in front, perhaps this would be possible. Today, when you have honored us with your presence, it feels it could be closer. Thank you. The children of Auroville would like to present to you some mementos from Auroville. This is a bowl made by the same technology that covers the gold discs of Matri Mandir. We are also presenting the Honorable Prime Minister with a scroll with some of the significant remarks that Mother makes about Auroville. Sir, you have honored our small experiment, experimental still, with your presence. Thank you so much. The audience is requested to remain seated while the Prime Minister exits the hall.
Good. Well done. Very good. Very good.
There are refreshments for all those who wish to stay a little longer outside. You're welcome to join us.
आप तो जा रहे हैं अब मैं जाऊं